Coming up, we've designed the new Microsoft Tech Community as a single place where experts in the community can share, collaborate, and learn across Microsoft products and services. Over the next few minutes, I'll show you how to personalize your experience, search for answers to your questions, and see and discuss popular event content. The Microsoft Tech Community is available for anyone to read, search, and view content posted without the need to sign in. But to get the full value to post, reply, or like the content you see, you'll need to sign up with your Microsoft account. So first thing you need to do is go to techcommunity.microsoft.com. Click on the prompt to sign in, and I'll be signing in as Katie today. And it will ask for your permission to use your profile. So here I'm at the onboarding experience. Here you can select a number of different communities for you to personalize your experience. I'm going to join a number of communities, starting with Delve, Excel, Office 365, and I'll add SharePoint as well. So after I've joined these communities, I can choose to add my organizational ID, which is my work email address, but that is optional. And I can then accept the terms of service. By accepting the terms of service and hitting submit, I should be a member of the new community. And I should be signed in as Katie Jordan. So here you can see that this is the landing page for the Microsoft Tech Community, and I want to see how I've personalized my experience by clicking my home in the navigation menu. So after clicking my home, you should be able to see all the communities that I've already joined as part of this demo. And you can see all of the latest conversations that are related to the communities that I've already joined, such as SharePoint, Office 365. I can also see all the most popular posts that have been here based on the number of replies and likes in this community. I can also see which conversations have had the most experts join these conversations. So we've deemed experts here in this community as MVPs, who are external experts in the community. We've also got Microsoft product managers. Any Microsoft employee has a ring around their avatar, which is blue. MVPs have green rings. And our community managers are also present here in the Microsoft Tech Community with red rings around their avatars as well. And simply by hovering over their avatars, you can see more detail about the roles that they're in here in the Microsoft Tech Community. Scrolling down a little bit further, you can see those four communities that I've just joined, but you also notice that at the very top here, there is a prompt telling me that there are no spaces that I've joined so far. So to just give you a little bit more of an explanation about spaces, let me go to the Office 365 community and show you a number of spaces that we have here. Think of each community as holding a number of different spaces to have different conversations. I could have conversations about admin center or developer and many more. And there are a number of different spaces that I can favorite using the heart icon at the very top right. By clicking here, these will be added as favorite spaces in my personalized home experience. Within this Office 365 community, you can see there are a number of things happening here. There are a number of announcements that I can see through the space on the right-hand side here. I can see the top contributors that are part of this particular community, such as our MVPs here as well. And you can also see all the different discussions around Office 365 that are populated through here as well. So let's take a look at the Office 365 space I've just favorited. As you can see, we have a number of different things we can see here. We can see featured conversations, such as this migration challenge conversation here. You can also see latest conversations that have been part of this Office 365 space. You can also see a number of relevant resources to Office 365 that we have, as community managers, pinned to the right-hand side. So what if I want to find an answer to my question? I can easily search the community for answers. For instance, I have a question about Office 365 governance, and quickly I can find responses populated via search. And I can see there's already a post about global admin, so I can click through to that response and see what I can find. After selecting this result, I can see this question has 16 different responses. I can get to an answer quickly by viewing best response. Now, as you participate in the community, you can also strengthen your community credibility. I've clicked on Jeremy's profile and I can see his information and latest contributions. If I click on achievements, I can see the badges that he's earned based on his activity in the community. The more you participate, the greater your involvement appears to others. So let me show you how to go about writing your first post. Since I was in the admin center space, it reminded me of Ann Michael's recent mechanics video, which I want to share with the community. I want to post a new post, so I'm going to click here and I'm going to type in the mechanics video for the admin center and paste my content. And I want to embed the video into my post so others can watch it. I can choose a label to make it easier for others to be able to find my posts through search. So I'm going to click on Office 365, add admin, and hit post. The tech community is also a hub for useful event-related learning content and discussions. For example, here I'm interested in seeing what information exists around Microsoft's Tech Summit events. I'm going to search for Tech Summit, and I'm interested in the Office 365 sessions, and I can see a post that has populated all the Office 365 sessions at the Tech Summit. I'm interested in learning more about groups, so I can click through and see if the session content, including a video recording of the session, is posted. The deck is also available to download. So that was a quick tour of the Microsoft Tech Community, your online community for discussion and best practices on Microsoft products you care most about. We hope that you'll head over to techcommunity.microsoft.com and sign up today. You can also follow us on Twitter for major news and posts we promote. Thanks for watching, and we'll hope to see you in the community.